All right, here we go, guys. Review 20 came out today. We've got it installed, and we're going to go and let's learn some of these features together. We'll pick them apart and see what we can do. Let's start with the custom lines that we can use now for our measurements. You can see I have a few here that I used for my screenshot in my blog at bluebeamandburgers.com. But what I want to show you is our measurements. Anytime we're doing, let's say, a poly length, we can come in, select that, right away go to our properties for that line before we place it, and we can go into our styles. And now we can go and load some advanced styles, build some custom ones, and select those. So in this case, let's go with a hot water line and come in here, select the path, whatever that looks like, double click when we're done. And there's our hot water line type and the total length. So now some other stuff that we can do here that's not new, but we'll go over it. I can also come over to my properties and click on show segment values. That'll show the length of each piece and then still have the total there. There was also in a forum earlier this week, somebody was asking what labels were for and what you would, what would those be used for. So let's put in hot water in the label and show you how. Oops, we need to turn that on here. Turn on the label. Now you can see that that pipe is labeled hot water and it's 55'1". Likewise with the area measurements, same thing there. If I come over to my measurement tab, click on my area. If I go over to my properties again before I start, while the tool is selected, I can come in and select our fence line and then come in and draw either a rectangle or whatever shape I want to here. Double click when I'm done. And that will lay out that line type on the exterior perimeter of our area measurement. So that is the custom lines for measurements. Next, we'll dive into that new hexagon text box. So if we jump in over here to the tools, markups, text box, you're all familiar with this. Click and drag, type in your text, and click off of it. It's going to give you a text box. This would be a good time to bring up the text boxes or callouts. Callouts are text boxes. So here, if I select this markup, you can see up here, it is a text box, but I can right click on it and add a leader, which I couldn't do before. And you'll see when I go around, it's going to go to the nearest point. I can select that point there. Another thing that is new in review 20, when I add a leader, it doesn't have to come off of that same elbow. It can go off of either side, wherever I want that to come off. So very nice feature there. I know in past, a trick that I learned from my buddy Sean in Australia, he would put in a white background for the text and then he would pull this across there and it would hide part of it behind that white. So no more workarounds there. You can pull those leaders wherever they need to. But then again, I can select that markup. And if you go over to your properties, we've got the rectangle. You can also switch to a circle. Different shapes in here. The triangle. And now we have a hexagon as well. And some tricks with this one too. Whatever shape you pick, you also want to come in here and maybe bump down the line spacing and the margin. And then right click and auto size your text box. And that will make that shape a little bit smaller, a little bit more reasonable size. That is your hexagon shape. All right, let's talk about the auto size font size for your multiline text. So in review 20, when I select my text, whether it's a text box or a call out again, or it could be a Cloud Plus, when I come over here and select auto for my text size, and I start to drag this, it's gonna scale all those different lines of text at the same time. In the past, in the previous versions, when you tried to do that, as soon as you select auto over here for a multi-line text, it would force it into one line and shrink it to fit in the box. So always a headache for me. This is a big one. They added a Find Tools feature. So when I go up here into my Help menu, right underneath that, you have Find Tools and Commands. So I can jump into the search there and start typing in a command. So C, it's going to give me everything that starts with a C. CL, O, and you can see as I keep typing those in, it's going to reduce the list to what fits that criteria. So now I have my Cloud Plus and my Cloud. Can pick on those and use those. One of the ones they list this year is the rendering speeds. They worked on the render speeds for heavily marked up drawings. I usually don't jump in and test those kinds of things, but again, my friend in Australia, Russell, he's tested these and he posted a lot better. So be on the lookout for that one as well. Okay, I'm kind of flying through these today. I know I don't always, I try not to leave long videos, so I'm making this as short as I can. We'll edit through some of the spots in between these tools as I'm working, but let's dive into our markups list and look at what they did this year. So you'll notice right at the top, they moved the filter list from over here over off to the side. And when I click on that, I have a new interface for my filters. You'll see in here that I can click on the command on the top of the column or comment, sorry. And you'll see that I have different choices, obviously, of the different markups. So I can filter it by the ones that have an A in it. So if I do that, and then I can also filter over here or any of them. So I can filter by multiple columns. I can come over and select only the ones that are accepted. Now it's going to filter the list to show me only the ones that fit both of those criteria. So come back in here, turn this to accepted, and you'll see both of those. You'll also see in here, if I click on the properties here for the filter list, I can save that. So I can save those and get the same results every time. I don't have to go through and reset this all the time for different projects and things like that. When I click on my accepted here and go into custom, you can also see here that we can filter by different equals, not equals, and the options are here. We can and or, we can also type in here greater than and less than and things like that to be able to search. So lots of great functionality to really whittle down your list and find the information you're looking for. And then also when we export these, whether we're doing a CSV or a PDF, there's now a new option down here to, if you click on options for your PDFs, you can include replies to your markups or exclude those. Same thing with the exporting to a CSV. If I click in there, you'll see replies on here. So you can turn that on or off, whatever you choose. When you're doing those estimates and things like that, when you have replies, sometimes that reply line in a spreadsheet will screw up your imports, exports, things like that. So you'll want to turn that on, turn it off. So we can do that now. And the last thing we'll show is the improvements to Studio, which I think are huge. And Studio is one of those things that's very much underutilized. It's a powerful tool. It's free for everybody. Hopefully some of these features that make it a little bit easier will introduce people to a great tool. So I'm going to jump over and look at our Studio tab and jump into a demo project here. And once I'm in here, I can look at my properties. Click on that. It brings up this window. And one of the things we can do now under the user access, you can see who's joined and who hasn't. So these guys are actually set to deny them access. But when I turn that on, I can also select them. You'll notice down here, email reminder to join. So you can send reminders to those that have been invited and haven't joined yet. You'll also see on both of these tabs, you have a not joined tab. So when I click on that, I can see the projects that I've been, the sessions that I've been invited to that I haven't joined yet. And then of course, all the ones that I normally have that I've joined. Same with projects, you have not joined and joined. So we don't have to worry about those projects and session invites being lost in our email. I know a lot of times with cities, when I work on electronic plan review, some of those will get lost in the firewall because they come from Bluebeam. So we don't have to worry about that anymore. It's going to show up in their account here under sessions and projects that they haven't joined yet. Some invite options. Let's jump into Studio again, and I'm going to go ahead and start a new session. We're going to call this Review 20. I'm going to select OK here. All right, in that Studio project, we have some new options to do invitations. I'm going to come over here and click on Invite in that demo project. And you'll see we have three different options here. We can copy paste emails. So I'm just going to click on that one. It gives you an example of what it's looking for here. I'm going to go down to my Outlook here off screen and grab a handful of emails, copy that, and I'm just going to paste it up here. And you can see all those emails in there. With all of the carrots and everything, that's okay. It's going to clean it up as soon as I click on check and include emails. It's going to clean up that list, show them all in here, and it's actually going to tell me there's 41 participants with the uscad.com domain. If you had anybody else, any other domains in there, it's going to list those with multiple different domains. So nice way to double check who's all invited and how many different domains. Another way you can do it is add emails by groups. Of course, you've got your address book. You can click on there and it's going to bring up whatever your, in my case, Outlook. So to keep it short, those are the ones I wanted to show you guys today, the big ticket ones. There's also some updates with the plugins, with AutoCAD 2021, Navisworks 2021, SketchUp Pro 2020. I haven't had a chance to test those yet, but let me know what you find out with those as well. Otherwise, I'm sure we'll be uncovering some more of those as we go, as we learn different workflows and things in future videos. Make sure that you subscribe.